Okay, I can't see her very good. Lucy's not doing well. She's outside. She has something wrong with her spine, I believe. She's yelping really bad. Doctor gave us some, I can't think of the stuff now. The growth hormone stuff. But anyway, and prescribing something for us, we can't even afford it until next week. So I think she hurt herself when she jumped off the porch last summer, or last fall rather, and we took her to the doctor. And sometimes she walks with her head down and her left paw inward, I mean actually bent back, I can't do it, it's too close, bent inwards, you know, so it's like the back of her paw touching the ground. And she yelps really bad. She can't jump up or jump down. I'm trying to keep her on the floor. I'm sitting on the floor with her as much as I can. I have to use a towel. The vet, Dr. Hicks, suggested to put like a towel underneath her and raise her up and down, you know, like a hand towel or a good sturdy towel folded in half. But she's outside, which is a good sign. You know, she's walking okay. She's 10 years old, which is not, I mean, for her type of dog, her size and her type, she's supposed to, they say 16, 17 years. So it's a little early for people to be saying, well, she's 10 years old. You know, now, if she was a German Shepherd or another big dog, 10, 11, 12 years old, yeah. Her should be 16, 17, 18 years of age before she gets where she is now. So when she jumped off the porch, she hurt herself. And Lucy! Lucy Lou! Hi, Lucy! Hi, sweetheart. You look so pretty. Let me see if I can zoom in on her. She's a pretty dog, isn't she? Pretty dog. Very smart. Very smart. She is just like you'd picture a kid in a movie, a comedy, where, you know, the kids are playing off their parents. She's kind of like pretend like she doesn't know, but when she knows everything we say and what we tell her, she knows that. But she'll do it like, you know, just like have her, you know, okay, if you say so. And then she'll call her and call her and call her. And then finally, when she's done, she comes. She's like a cat. She'll just come when she's ready. Yeah, she's laying down there. That's her daughter's gray right there, CJ. I can zoom out. Where's that right there? That's where we buried CJ. December 17th, 2013. So I thought maybe she can come out here. See, yeah, she's laying down now. She just laid. Yeah. So she start yelping or something. If something touches her, bug or something. Yeah, I got two peas for three holes. So that's six, and then one in each of the last two holes. I mean, it's more. It'll be more than what we want. We need really, but. Like I said, I like peas and carrots. That's what they're for. We just don't have carrots. We have to go buy carrots. I wish I knew more, better about how to grow carrots, too, because we could get seeds from Heirloom Solutions for carrots. It's one of those ones where I'm guessing you plant it in the fall or something like that, and then I don't know if it's like next year they come up, you know, and I don't know. It's like cabbages. We have all those cabbage and lettuce and try planting that stuff, it started growing, then it just died off, so I don't know anything about that stuff. It's all trial and error. But we got a lot growing. A lot. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 7, 10. 10 purple hull peas right here. 3 in one row, 3 in another, 2, 3. And it's like, man, all together. I'm hoping they'll grow like that, okay. It'll be crowded in this area. But, should be a really, really good garden. We'll get the tomatoes and peppers. They'll be in the front gardens. That's number two garden right here. Number one garden's over there. We got some eggplant. No, yeah, we got eggs. No, we don't have eggplant in here yet. That's where eggplant's gonna go. We got tomatillos and I believe it's squash. We're not sure. And some beans. Purple pole beans. We got those two hummingbird feeders as like guides for the string. And like I said, we got the hummingbird feeders on there too, so to attract the hummingbirds over here. We have butterflies over here, probably bees too, unfortunately, but need bees to pollinate stuff too. Lucy, she's smiling when the wind blows, she just pick her head up. She's such a pretty dog. wind knocked this camera over earlier. From my mom's swing. She's over by mom's swing. She just started walking over slowly.
I'm gonna go in and labor out here with you when you go in. Probably tired of standing up.
Yeah. Need to be outside, get some chemtrailed contaminated air. Daddy made that ramp around back for you to go up so you don't have to use the steps. Right, Lucy? That's my girl. That's Daddy's girl. That's a good girl. Oh, that's a good girl. You want to come with Daddy now? Let's go around back where the ramp is out back. Come on, Lucy, around back. Come on, Lucy, round back. That's a good girl. I'm just gonna set this over here on a cooler for now. I put in with the topsoil later on for planting this little topsoil, and then I got fertilizer on top with it. Come on, Lucy, let's go around back here. Go up the ramp I made for you. Come on, girl. That's a good girl. That's a good girl. So usually she runs all the time. If you ever seen any videos of her before running, I doubt probably outside. Okay, you used to walk up the ramp. Go up the ramp. Oh, she went up the steps. Good girl. Good girl, Lucy. I'll be in there in 2 minutes. I'm gonna put that stuff in the bucket. Alright, there's Lucy Lou. The 23rd of April. That would have been CJ's birthday. Passed over. We had to put down in December of 2013. She has head cancer. So, anyway, that's Lucy Lou.